right, race fans, up next, the big finale, the late model 30-lap feature. Starting at the rear of the field in the white and blue, 26, it's Brandon Gardner. The 56 is Hugh Scalp. The blue 7 is William Overby. The double 0 is Ted Lowe. The 11 is Kip Sawyer. On the third row is the 83 of Shane Roberts. The 2 is Mitchell Childress. Row 2, the 23, Lane Clifton. Inside row 2, the 31 is Brad Siegel. Outside row number 1, the 169 of Stone Fuller. The 29 is Rusty Ballinger. Once again, happy to have with us tonight Speedway Videos, capturing all the racing action here at 411 Motor Speedway, Tennessee's action track. Next time by, we will be green. 30-lap feature in the late models, the 29, Rusty Ballinger, 169 of Stone Fuller. Darting around on the outside, bumpity bump is the 169 of Fuller. He will sneak away the lead from the 29 of Ballinger. Now Ballinger settles down on the inside groove at the flag stand. It will be the 169 of Stone Fuller, 29 Ballinger, 23 of Clifton, fourth spot, the 31 of Brad Siegel. Stone Fuller, a slowed car. The 56 of Scalp has now brought out a caution. The 56 is right up in the race groove with the leaders coming on. Tough luck for the 169 of Stone Fuller. It's been coming up to 411 Motor Speedway. That young man is getting better and better and better. This may have been his night, but due to the circumstances, it's not going to be his night to win a feature event. Wish the team of the 169 and the family of Stone Fuller best wishes. Hope to see him back in the near future. Race fans, as most can see over behind the Sevier County Rescue Squad vehicle, that's the driver, the 169, has a steady enough balance to evaluate his race car. Stone, old buddy, I think you had him covered tonight. Tough luck. What a great qualifying effort up on the front row, getting around another veteran driver of Ballinger. On the Speedway. have another caution on the front straightaway. It's the same 56 of Scalp. The 7 of Overby. I hope these drivers see the caution, 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 caution. Still on the point, it's the 29 of Rusty Ballinger, 23 Lane Clifton, 31 Brad Siegel. Diving underneath for a third spot, the 83 of Shane Roberts, getting around the 31 of Siegel. That's going to allow the 29 of Ballinger sneak away with the 3-car length lead over the 23 of Lane Clifton. The 00 of Lowe's. Lowe's coming out of turn number 4. That would allow the 26 of Gardner to get around for an 8th spot. This time at the flag stand, 9 on the board, 21 to go for the 29 of Rusty Ballinger. Up to 2nd spot is still the 23 of Lane Clifton. Battling is the 83 of Shane Roberts. And here comes the 31 of Brad Siegel. Second spot is the 83 of Shane Roberts. Now fine battle for third with the 23 of Clifton, the 31 of Siegel. Once again, coming up on lap traffic. 14 on the board, 16 to go for the 29 of Rusty Ballinger. Manipulating his way through lap traffic is your leader, Rusty Ballinger. About a 14 car length lead over the 83 of Shane Roberts. Time by coming out of turn 4. 20 on the board, 10 to go for the 29 of Rusty Ballinger. 26 of Brandon Gardner. Once again, a little loose coming out of turn number two, but he'll gather up and go down the back straightaway at the flag stand. Once again, it's the 29 of Rusty Ballinger. Now has a half a track lead over the 83 of Shane Roberts. Run in third spot for the 23 of Lane Clifton. Still battling the 31 of Brad Siegel. Down the back straightaway into turn number three is the 29 of Rusty Ballinger. Now about a 14 car length lead over the 83 of Shane Roberts. Working his way around lap traffic. A year later, the 29 of Rusty Ballinger started on the pole. He's led 27 laps. Will he hold on for the final three? Now cutting down about 10 car lengths is the 83 of Shane Roberts. Then it's back to third spot, the 23 of Lane Clifton, with a fine battle with the 31 of Brad Siegel. Out of turn number four, laying him down is the 29 of Rusty Ballinger, takes the white flag. Now he sets his sights on a clean and green racetrack going down the back straightaway. Looking up on the flag stand, flagman Lynn Palmer waving the checkered flag. $1,000 for the 29 of Rusty Ballinger. Run the 83 of Shane Roberts, coming home a solid third. Lane Clifton, fourth spot, the 31 of Brad Siegel.
Flew through the scales, got that checker flag from Joe Bird, and he said, let's go over here and talk to that silly old announcer. I believe he's winning, leading the points, but he'll talk to us about that. Started on the pole, had somebody sneak around him on the early laps, but he fought his way back to victory lane. Let's hear it for tonight's winner, and the late models, the 29 of Rusty Ballinger. Congratulations, buddy. I wish you could have seen that look he just gave me. Oh, wow, that was something else. Rusty, before we talk to you about those last 26 laps, let's talk about the first four. You had the pole. You had a young man that's not been here in a couple of months, and I understand from our track officials he's been working diligently, hard, his entire family and team, on getting his race car out here. That's the 169 of Stone Fuller. And, young man, if you're up there, you're your family and your team, we understand how hard you worked. Congratulations to you. Talk to us about those first laps when Stone got around you and then the unfortunate happening with him and then the last 26 laps.
Well, first, I hate it for him. He's been learning real hard, and he had a good car. I can't do good here on the start on the bottom, and he got the lead on me, and I was just going to ride it out till we got the lap traffic, and I really don't know what happened. I don't know if the guy broke or what, and he had nowhere to go. I just hate it for him, but just glad we got to miss it.
All right, Rusty. Now, before you go, talk to me about, we just got, I think, a couple events left with the points. Where do you stand in the 2013 Late Model Championship points?
Well, I think we about got it beat now. I don't know. All my crew, everybody looks at that all the time. I really don't know. I just try to come out here and win every week, but I think we about got it.
You just like winning and driving to Old Smoky Victory Lane. Rusty, before we let you go, you'll be with us, of course, next Saturday night?
Oh, yeah, I'll be here.
All right, talk to us about some of your sponsors before we let all of our wonderful fans leave.
I'd like to thank Tommy Newton at TNN Race Engines, Ron, HVH this week. helping me out, my dad, West Taxidermy, AutoZone, and all my crew up there. Thank you.
All righty, let's hear it one more time for tonight's winner, the 29 of Rusty Ballinger. And from all I understand, the 2013 track champion. From all of us here at 411 Motor Speedway, we ask you to drive home safely. God bless. Godspeed. See you next Saturday night. Wear pink. The fight against breast cancer. Thank you, folks.